Hello dear students, today we will start with our new topic of English, that is point of view. Now in this chapter, first we have activity 1, read the following newspaper article from the Jalandhar News. So students, you need to read this article and you need to tell us what is the main point of view. Means what are the points of view, what is it based on? मतलब कि जो पूरा चैप्टर है या पूरा ये जो आर्टिकल है इसमें मेन न्यूज़ क्या है, इसमें आपको क्या पता चलता है इस आर्टिकल से. एंड देन आफ्टर दिस वी हैव एक्टिविटी 2. व्हेन राइटर टेल्स द आइडियाज ऑफ अदर पीपल दे कैन डू इट इन डिफरेंट वेज. वन वे इज टू शो द एग्जैक्ट वर्ड्स ऑफ द पर्सन बाय यूजिंग डायरेक्ट कोटेशन. Another way is to stay very close to the words and meaning but without using a direct quotation. This can be called reported speech. So now normally when we talk to someone and jo unke exact words hote hain, hum agar wo kisi ko bata rahe hain, that is direct quotation. But agar hum unke jaise jo unhone bola waise hi same words use kar rahe hain, so that is called reported speech. For example, this is an example of a direct quotation. The author uses quotation marks to shows us that the words inside them are exactly the words that Ben said. So Ben said, do you mean that you enjoy it? Question mark. Okay. So direct quotations are written inside quotation marks. They show the exact words of the source. So now you would like to know what is source. So the meaning of source is any kind of information which we can get from anywhere. That is a source. Writing a person's ideas in quotation marks shows that the writer is using the exact words of the person. If a writer needs to change the exact words, this must be indicated with different punctuation marks. So whenever you are writing the exact words, they should be in quotation marks. This is an example of reported speech. Reported speech tells us the meaning of what Ben said but changes the grammar so that no quotation marks are used. Reported speech is often used in newspapers. So now Ben asked Tom if he meant that he enjoyed painting the fence. So students, this is what is reported speech. Okay, next we have is activity 3. Remember that a summary of a source is about the source. So a summary of chaos reigns as traffic rules are ignored by Jatin Singh will not be about parking. It will be about the main ideas of the author, Jatin Singh. The author's main idea is his point of view, his own judgment of the situation. Now, whatever the author wants to say or what the writer wants to say, that will be his point of view. Okay, for example, if the incident is happening, agar kuch bhi ho raha hai wahan pe, to aap usko kis tarah describe karoge, that will be your point of view. So this is what is happening here. So point of view is a particular way of thinking about something. Your point of view is influenced by the type of person you are and by your experiences, and everyone has a unique point of view. After this we have activity 4. Point of view is a common idiom. Idioms are group of words that have a special meaning that is different from the ordinary meaning of each separate word. The best way to understand idioms is to listen and observe how they are used in different ways. So students, you already know what are idioms. Here we have, think about these sentences that use the idiom, put it in perspective. There are so many details, I have to look at the big picture to put it all in perspective. He is really upset and scared to drive because he had a small car accident, but he needs to put it in perspective. It was just one time and he and the car are okay. The unemployment rate seems high, but you have to put it in perspective. It's lower than it was last year. So students, please read this and go through it. We will continue with activity 5 in our next video. Thank you.